What's up, guys? The OCG recently got their list, which will be effective starting on October 1st, 2015. Normally, our DCG list should, have had the same date. Although, as we all know, recently Konami DCG decided not to set an end date for our DCG list because they don't, and I quote, want to limit their flexibility, since sometimes it's hard to hit a certain card that might become a problem rather than because it was a problem. So, according to Kevin Toward from Konami, their problem was that they were locked into only changing the list on specific dates, so that when the time is right, they update the list. And thus, they can change the list whenever they feel like it. I'll leave a link to the article in the video description, so feel free to check it out. For me, as a player who has been playing this game pretty much ever since the beginning, and I'm loving the game ever since, this is bullcrap. Don't get me wrong, I understand that updating the ban list takes time. Testing problem cards slash combos, discussing them, future set releases that need to sell, because, yeah, we all know the ban list is a little more focused on boosting sales and not hurt the new archetypes slash new booster packs, well, most of the time that is, but you know what I mean. Anyway, I'm just saying that I'm not a fan of this void, uncertainty that we in the DCG are having now because we have no idea when we can expect our new DCG list. And let's face it, I think we are all fed up with the current top tier decks like Necro, Satella Knights, Shadals, and so on. A fresh breeze is definitely welcome. Before I start, guys, these are just my thoughts on the possible upcoming ban list. It's perfectly fine if you have another opinion about certain cards or card choices. Please don't be that guy calling someone an idiot. So again, this is all speculation and I'm happy to read your own card choices, opinions and so on down below. Alright, let's start off. Again, we don't know when our next TCG list will drop, but seeing that the OCG list will start October 1st, 2015, we might see an update for our TCG list somewhere in October, worst case maybe even in November. For the new TCG list, there's a very big chance that the current top tier decks, so Necros, Shadals, Satella Knights and Clifords, oh and of course Burning Abyss, are getting hits. Reasoning for this is perfectly clear, I think. The recent release of the Megatins reprinted almost everything for these top tier decks. And let's face it, the new Megatins were selling like hotcakes. And for a good reason, I mean, they were excellent. Guaranteed good promo cards like Norden and Majesty's Fiend, multiple holos in every pack. It was excellent. It was an excellent buy. It also was a great strategy from Konami that after a few weeks, or maybe after a few weeks, when the new Megatins are sold out in a lot of places, that the top decks are getting hit. And depending how strong they were in today's format, or how long that they have been part of the metagame, a particular deck will get hit harder than the other one. So, the cards that might get banned for the new 2015 October ban list. For me, we have three possibilities here. Two of them definitely should be banned. The third one is Living on the Edge. First, we have Roll Magical Library. It's a card that should have been banned a long time now. It's always involved in degenerate loops, slash FTK and OTK decks. Also, the Edge that it gives to Ignite players, drawing into it is huge. I'm not saying this is the reason that it should be banned, but you know what I mean. Library is 100% not a healthy card and therefore deserves a ban. The next one is a card that should also have been banned with the gin releaser of Rituals on our previous list. Vanity's Emptiness wins and steals games and is one of the best floodgates out there, like what happened with Sixth Sense and Return from a Different Dimension. Players are asking to their opponent to side out Emptiness in the mirror match because it gives the player that's able to draw into it a huge and unfair advantage in winning the duel. The last card here is Raigeki. Sure, it's a power creeped card in today's format since most decks quote-unquote float, so are just hardly affected by Raigeki. But still, yeah, in every deck profile I do of a player in a tournament, they say how many games they won and maybe stolen by the cards by Raigeki, and that amount is just too damn high. Raigeki banned will most likely not happen, but is possible. Next, the cards that have the possibility to get limited on our new TCG list. Let's start with Burning Abyss, a deck that has been around for a long time now. It has been taking a few hits like Tour Guide, but it was able to survive with ease. There are a few possibilities here. Monster cards like Sur or maybe even Groff have the chance to get limited. Dante is also a big candidate here, but I'll come back to that in a few moments. Then we have Clyfort. The pay 800 memes are everywhere, and a lot of people are just fed up with the deck. Tower Turbo is one of the possibilities of playing Clyforts, and it's just pure degeneracy at its finest. A lot of people want to X Taurus itself. Personally, I'm not a huge fan of this, since there are a lot of outs to Taurus itself, but yeah, I understand that not every deck has easy access, main deckable access to Taurus, like for example Crab King. Crab King, the Exceed, is not allowed over here in Europe, just to name an example. Possible ways to hit Clyforts, the searches. I mean, take away something from their consistency, like hitting Scout 2-1, which is a hard hit, or maybe even Summoner's Art, the searcher. Yeah, people are saying that Stealth or the other floodgates, like Lose One Turn, should get hit too. I'm not sure about this though. Then we have Shadals, currently crippled in the OCG, but I don't think it should get the same treatment like it had in the OCG. The biggest candidates here are, I think, both Construct, El Shaddoll Construct, and El Shaddoll Fusion. I don't think I need to explain this. 3 Construct in their extra deck is almost a no-brainer, since it's so easy to summon and the insane amount of advantage you get by summoning it is very good. The Catastrophe effect is also very nice, of course. El Shaddoll Fusion pushes for the OTK and can be reused when one of the fusions or core is sent to your graveyard. So taking away some consistency to Shaddolls is definitely welcome. For me, any kind of hit to these two cards is definitely possible, but will Konami do this? I don't know, of course. Then we have, I think, the most hated deck in today's format. We have Necros. The deck has survived a lot of hits in both the TCG and OCG, and it still manages to take a lot of top cut spots in every tournament, for a good reason, since their searching capabilities are through the roof. Every card searches out each other in the deck. It's insane. So possible hits, yeah. We have a few, hitting the Manju, the Senju, basically the Stratos, limiting maybe Brionek and or Unicore won't come as a surprise if Konami wants to do that. Hitting one of the mirrors maybe, yeah, that's possible, it's definitely possible, like the Cycle or whatever. Personally, I won't mind a huge hit on this deck in all honesty. And last, we still have Satella Knights. For a lot of people, the biggest candidate to take the hardest hit in the upcoming TCG ban list. The biggest reason for this is that they won Worlds this year, and following Konami's strength of nuking the winning deck, like they did last year with Infernities and Sehabi winning the World Championship in Rimini, it makes Konami so that they might drop a bomb on Tellers. I'm not sure if they are completely going to nuke the deck, but I'm sure it will get a hit. Inconsistency and searching. So yeah, possibilities. Rota, Reinforcement of the Army, is a card that I might see go to 1. Altair, by many people getting shot, hit a card to 1. I don't know. Altair to 2 seems more reasonable. Same with Stellar Nova Alpha, the counter trail. Yeah, the trap card might be that extra nuke by Konami. I don't think it's needed, but yeah, if they want, they can kill the deck completely. Triver might be a candidate as well, but we'll see what Konami is going to do in the near future. Oh, and one more card that needs to be limited, this guy, Norden. I don't think that I need to explain this, right? Then the cards that might get semi-limited. As mentioned earlier, Dante is also a big candidate to get some kind of hit, either to 2 or to 1 maybe. Next to other hits as well, as mentioned earlier, like Sur or Groff, which won't come as a surprise if Konami does that. Same with Altair, next to Rota, a very big candidate to take a hit for Satella Knights. And last, Book of Moon. For me, one of my favorite cards, quick play spell cards here, to come back to 2. It's a very skillful card. It's also very versatile, since it can be used both offensive and defensive for a quote-unquote cost of it being a -1. But still, it's a very powerful card. But yeah, will most likely not come back to 2. Lost a few cards that probably can come back off of the list. First, Tragodia. Why not? Once it was a big threat in French Twilight, Light Swords. Dragon's Ravine might have the chance to come back as well. And following the trend of Darkhold and Raigeki, Darkhold might come back to 3 with the possibility of Raigeki being banned, but again, this will most likely not happen. Alright, that's it. Let's end the list with a few cards that didn't make it to the list, but do deserve a mention here. The first one is, of course, Elemental Hero Stratos. Hashtag Free Stratos, we all know that one, but nope. Same with all the previous TCG lists, this card definitely won't come back because simple, Konami says so. Ptolemaios is a very strong card, it's going to be banned in the OCG, but I don't think this card needs to be hit or banned in a TCG for now. Same with Towers for Glyphords, there are other cards to hit if you want to hit Glyphords. And last but not least, the endless debate. Should Heavy Storm come back to our format? The OCG has Harpy's Feather Duster, so why can't we have Heavy Storm? A big threat to Floodgates, and when it was around, we didn't really have those summon set 4 or set 5 opening moves. Bar, of course, if the player had Starlight Road or Solemn Judgment, or they were bluffing them. I'm not sure about Heavy Storm. We currently also have Denko Seka, which is also a card that might deserve a mention here. It's difficult. So for me, that's it. Guys, if you have any opinions about the list here, any card choices you think should get hit, you can always leave those down below. Guys, this is it. Thanks for watching and feel free to leave a comment or a like if you enjoyed the video. Leave them signing out. Peace.